Relax, Jimmy. I'm just saying, I'll sign it when I'm ready.
And all I'm saying is that HR could be weird about deadlines. If you don't sign your contract on time...
Look, maybe I'm looking for a sign on whether or not to re-up for another 5 years.
Yeah, what the heck?
Oh, that's never a good sound.
Agent Parker?
The flask, Jimmy. Don't open it.
What?
Code 2 alert. Biotoxin detected.
Okay, what is happening?
Automatic lockdown. The flask contains some kind of biotoxin Mass Spec does not like.
I'm guessing this isn't the sign you're looking for.
What is it, two bumps in a slap?
No.
Agent Torres.
Oh, hey, Director.
Is that Victoria Palmer?
Hi, Director. Just visiting.
How nice. It's good to see you again. Agent Torres, did you receive the code 2 alert on Miss Hines' lab?
Code 2? That's a lockdown.
What lockdown?
Was anybody besides Jimmy and Casey exposed?
Why is there a lockdown? Are Casey and my dad in trouble?
No. Victoria, see, Mass Spec is programmed to do that automatically.
Something bad happened, didn't it? I want to see my dad.
And how do we make that happen?
Well, Casey's lab is sealed up, so her office is safe. She could talk to him through the glass doors.
Good.
Can we?
Hell yeah. Come on, let's go.
Okay, first we need to get whatever Casey identified in that flask over to CDC for analysis.
Already done. Mass Spec does that automatically.
Great. Also, we need anything we can find on this Raven creep. And as far as Jimmy and Casey go, I don't suppose we have a good toxicologist on speed dial?
Actually, we do.
CDC's sending her now. One of their top experts in biotoxins.
Who's he talking about?
An old friend. A good one.
The next thing we know, Mass Spec is wailing, and every door in here just slams shut.
Hey, at least we know the system works.
Yeah, maybe a little too well. I mean, as you can see, sweetheart, we are both fine.
And what fine mess have we gotten ourselves into this time, Jimmy?
Hey, Carol, you guys went straight to the top.
Hey, for you and Casey, only the best.
Torres, right?
Yes.
I hear good things.
And they're all true. And you are?
Nick, do you seriously not know Dr. Carol Wilson? Oh my gosh.
You never told me you know her.
You never told me you know her.
Oh my gosh, Dr. Wilson, excuse me, Dr. Wilson, I so admire your work. My college dissertation was all about your Ebola research.
Carol, please. That is so sweet and doesn't make me feel old at all. And you?
I'm Victoria.
Come on, Jimmy. Are you serious? You mean to tell me that this beautiful young lady is your baby, Victoria? Man, I swear, between her and McGee's twins, time is just flying by.
Speaking of time, Carol?
Nice segue, McGee. Okay, here's the deal. Until we have more information, protocols call for the two of you to sit tight in there. Now, I admit I am not familiar with this compound that you inhaled, but it seems similar to a VX-type gas. And I already have two calls in to my friend, Yuri Pastov.
Didn't Pastov create some of these biotoxins to begin with?
Yes, until he defected to the U.S. last year to create some antidotes. Look, if anybody can help us, Yuri can.
Then they're going to be okay?
Don't you worry at all, okay? Your job is to make sure that Dad and Casey don't drive each other crazy in there until I can get back, okay?
Ice cream check, what'd you get?
Rocky Road.
Rocky Road, how many scoops?